Hey guys, sometimes we want to interrupt our applications or at least restrict some access to certain portions of our application depending on some criteria. The powerful part of Laravel that allows us to do this is called middleware. So middleware is a way for us to interrupt our applications. I like calling it an interruption because you have this regular flow of the application whenever you request a URL. So when you request a URL up at the top, it's kind of like, well, what's going to load and what path does that take? So a lot of times it's kind of like, think of it like if you're going to log in and you're logging into the application, well, I shouldn't be able to get to any part of the admin area without having to log in. Well, I need some sort of interruption. I need some way to check the user's current session and see if they're logged in. If they are, then allow them to go through this admin area. And the way we do that is with middleware. Now, authentication is kind of already built in into Laravel, and it already has middleware kind of attached. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of create a little test middleware, and I'm pulling this straight from the documentation here in Laravel, and we're going to do this age middleware here. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to go over to our terminal. We're going to make sure that we're here in the path of our bloggy.dev. If you're not there, then you're going to go to CD, Homestead. If you're not there, you're going to go to CD and then Projects, bloggy.dev, and then you can just do that to get to there. So one thing we're going to run, it's going to be kind of our first time running, is this PHP Artisan tool. So I'm going to do PHP Artisan, and that gives me kind of a lot of options here to do stuff. Artisan is just really a PHP file. So all we're doing is saying, when we do this, is saying PHP and then some file name.php or something like that. Except the only thing different here is that Artisan just doesn't have a file extension. So all we're going to run is PHP Artisan space and then the name of whatever we want to run. See, if I just hit return right here, we're talking about middleware. So you can see right here, make middleware. Create a new middleware class. PHP Artisan make middleware. But is that all I do? Well, we can pass this space dash H to kind of get some additional information here. Well, it's make middleware. Oh, I'm supposed to pass a name here. So I'm going to just say PHP Artisan make middleware age middleware. Before I hit return, I want you to see here, we're going to go over to our code under app, HTTP middleware. This is where that new file will show up. Hit return, says successfully created. I go here and there's the age middleware. So this is kind of like a little template or a little shell that we have to kind of interact with this. So remember that I was talking about somebody hits a URL, and if we hit a URL here, like this blog.post or just the regular, you know, the regular route here, bloggy.dev. Even though this loaded fast, there was a lot of stuff that happened behind the scenes. It kind of checked for things. And this request, I guess life cycle, you could call it, there's ways that we can interrupt that cycle and that request. So here you have age middleware, and you can see that it's already loaded. It's like, I want to handle. We're passing the request inside the function. So the request being whatever's here in the URL. I want to get to a location. And here, this is saying, okay, here's the request, then go ahead and go to that location. So that's what this is. So remember earlier I talked about middleware is pretty much an interruption. So if I leave this alone, nothing really happens. It just, everything works the way it should. I mean, there's some other configuration I got to do here to get this to work. But everything should just continue to work, and the request should be able to do the same because I'm not really interrupting the route or the request per se. If I'm going to do an interruption, I'm going to do it right here. I'll go ahead and say interrupt, and that's the way we're going to be interrupting here. So here I'm going to say if, I'm going to check the request of the input, age, if that is less than 200, then I want you to return redirect to home. So here, looking at this code, I'm saying if the requested age is less than 200, don't let them go to this next request. I want you to interrupt it, and there's that word again, and redirect them to the home. So you think about this in other kind of like real life scenarios. It's like if the person's not logged in, then don't let them go to this area. If we look at this authenticate here, this is in the middleware right here, auth guard guest. So if the person's a guest, then redirect them to login. Don't worry about this stuff right now, but redirect them to login. So here we already have an authentication middleware. If the person's a guest, redirect them to login. That's perfect. Here, if the person is less than 200, redirect them to home. So a lot of times you think of this as being kind of like the, you know, this is age middleware. I'm checking for the opposite of what I want. And then I'm going to interrupt that opposite and send it somewhere or make it do something. So that way I have this logic kind of intact. The other thing that we want to do here is on the age middleware, once we create a middleware, we want to tell the application to use it. And we can give it a shortcut name. So here, if I'm going to go inside a kernel, here you can see that we have some other middleware kind of in place here. You have middleware groups, and then you have route middleware. Remember I was talking about the authenticate. Well, it's already there. So now we need to connect this age middleware to our application. So we do that in kernel.php. And kernel.php is under HTTP. So kernel.php, route middleware. You can see that we already have the auth class there, and that's for authentication, so that middleware is already kind of intact. And here I'm going to say I want to do age check, and this is kind of a label for this, and it's going to be under app HTTP middleware, and it's called age middleware, and we do class. And then that's all we need to do. And now it's kind of tied to our application. We can use this. So here it's like route middleware. Now I'm going to go over to the routes right here and create and actually use this middleware. So remember, again, I'm saying that once we go here in the request, I want to be able to do something in be able to do some logic if something doesn't pass. So here I'm saying route get fountain of youth. If I could spell youth. And then here is something a little different. I want to say middleware. Middleware. I want you to use middleware for this route, and I want you to do age check. And then we do the function here. Make sure we semicolon that. So this is something a little bit different here. We can kind of return this to make it look a little bit better if we want to. See that, hey, here I'm trying to get this at the URL, and I want you to attach this middleware called AgeCheck. Remember, AgeCheck is that label that we created right here, and then it's attached to this middleware. So I do this, and I'm going to go to Fountain of Youth. Everything, actually, I still didn't spell it correctly, so Fountain of Youth. Youth, and you can see there in the age, I already kind of tested it. So here it says return to home. It says bloggy.dev return to home. As you can see, I don't even have a home in my URL. You could fix that real quick by just saying route get home function, and we're just going to return not old enough. Not old enough. So here I'm going to try and go and say, hey, I want to be able to go to the Fountain of Youth right now. It says, nope, you're not old enough. You have to be 200 or over 200. So here I'm going to do the same thing, Fountain of Youth, and let's return a nice message. Let's say return 100 years have been added to your life. And here I'm saying age is equal to 25. So this right here is an input. It's a query string. If we look at our age middleware, we're saying, hey, I want to grab the request. Well, this is the request. And I want you to look for the request to see if there's an input of age. Well, there is. Grab that value. And if it's less than or equal to 200, then redirect to home. If it's not, then here in the route where we attach the middleware, this is where we put what we wanted to do when it passes. There we go, hit return. 100 years have been added to your life, and now I will live to be 305. So this is middleware. Again, middleware, don't make it more complicated than it is. Really, all it is a way for us to interrupt our applications because we want to check for something or we want something to pass before we send the person on to the next request. Well, I really hope you enjoyed that. If you want to learn more about Laravel and what Laravel has to offer, come check it out on SitePoint Premium. I can't wait to see you there.